بدعة، كل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. الله سبحانه وتعالى mentioned some آيات, some verses about الصيام in سورة البقرة. And in between them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned an ayah about الدُّعَاء. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ. And when my servants ask you concerning me, ask you, it means Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, indeed I am near. Indeed, I am near. I respond to the invocation of the supplicant when he calls upon me. The scholars mention the point or the aim or the wisdom in mentioning this ayah after a few ayat of al-siyam because Ramadan is the month of dua. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned that three people or three types of people, Allah will not reject their dua. And he mentioned الصائم حتى يفطر, the fasting person until he breaks his fast, which means from الفجر until المغرب, from the dawn until the sunset. This is a very good time for all of us to invoke Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And the dua is a great worship. You should focus on the dua to invoke Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Don't think about the answer. Don't think about the response. Where is the answer from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You should focus on the dua because itself is a worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ ادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. And your Lord says, call upon me, I will respond to you. So what is our job? To invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the promise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to answer. So you should focus on the first part. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us to invoke him. وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ دُعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. Then he said, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ عَنْ عِبَادَتِي سَيْدُخُلُونَ جَهَنَّمَ دَاخِرِينَ. Indeed, those who disdain my worship will enter hell. Contemptible. Which means the one who doesn't invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is arrogant. As if he's saying, I don't need, oh, you, Allah. And actually, all of us, we need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because al-du'a huwa al-ibadah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, supplication is itself the worship. Like the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-hajju arafah. Which means this is the main, the most important pillar in hajj. And here the hadith, al-du'a huwa al-ibadah, the main thing in our Islam, in our religion, is al-du'a. Al-du'a. We need to invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala day and night. And if you avoid asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you think, I don't need anything. I already have my family, my car, my job, everything is fine. So no need to invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is wrong. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من لم يسأل الله يغضب عليه. Subhanallah. Indeed, he who doesn't ask Allah, he gets angry with him. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala day and night. He will not subhanahu wa ta'ala. The treasures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the rizq of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the sustenance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not finish. Don't think that if I ask Allah, you ask Allah, and the people in the West and the East, everywhere, when they ask Allah, His khazain, subhanahu wa ta'ala, His provision will finish. Nothing will finish from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He will answer you. I like to mention some of the important ayat from the Quran. Some of the prophets, alayhim salatu wa salam, who are the best people. They are better than me and you and everyone, the messengers and the prophets, alayhim salatu wa salam. They invoked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sincerely. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed them the answer in dunya. The first prophet is Nuh alayhi salatu wa salam. He called his people 950 years, almost 1,000 years. Alfa sana illa khamsina aama. 950 years. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned only few people followed him. وَمَا آمَنَ مَعَهُ إِلَّا قَلِيلٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned only few people believed in Nuh, followed Nuh, accepted Islam. So they tried at the end to punish Nuh or to kill Nuh or to fight Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about Nuh, وَنُوحًا إِذْ نَادَى مِنْ قَبْلُ فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ فَنَجَّيْنَاهُ وَأَهْلَهُ مِنَ الْكَرْبِ الْعَظِيمِ. And mention Nuh, when he called to Allah before that time, so we responded to him and saved him and his family from the great affliction. وَنَصَرْنَاهُ مِنَ الْقَوْمِ الَّذِينَ كَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِنَا. And we aided, saved him from the people who denied our signs. So Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam was in a very little group of believers and the whole community against them. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam. The next prophet, Ayyub. Ayyub alayhi salatu wasalam. النبي الذي he suffered, the prophet who suffered many years in disease. Everyone left him except maybe two people and his wife. And he was a prophet, a messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. The prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam mentioned he was sick for 18 years. Everyone left him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about Ayyub, Ayyub, إِذْ نَادَى رَبَّهُ أَنِّي مَسَّنِيَ الضُّرُّ وَأَنْتَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. And mention Ayyub. When he called to his Lord, indeed adversity has touched me, and you are the most merciful of the merciful. عليه الصلاة والسلام. After suffering so many years, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered him. فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ فَكَشَفْنَا مَا بِهِ مِنْ ضُرُّ وآتيناه أهله ومثلهم معهم. So we responded to him and removed what afflicted him of adversity. And we gave him back his family and the like thereof with them as mercy from us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered his dua. Don't give up. After 18 years, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered his dua. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. It doesn't mean Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't like Ayyub, or Ayyub was doing a great sin. When he repented, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removed this adversity. This is wisdom from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For Ayyub after 18 years. For Nuh after 950 years. For me maybe after 1 year. For you until death, you will see your reward in the akhirah. The point is, وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ دُعُونِي. Our job is to invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At the end of ayah of Ayyub alayhi salatu wasalam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَذِكْرَى لِلْعَابِدِينَ. And a reminder for the worshippers, which means this is not only for Ayyub, this is all for all people who are following the steps of Ayyub alayhi salatu wasalam. If you are a real worshipper of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, invoke Allah sincerely, Allah will answer your dua. Yunus, the prophet of the whale, the friend of the whale, or the companion of the whale, وَذَنُّون. إِذْ ذَهَبَ مُغَاضِبًا فَظَنَّ أَلَّا نَقْدِرَ عَلَيْهِ فَنَادَى فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ أَلَّا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ سُبْحَانَكَ إِنِّي كُنْتُ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ. فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and mentioned the man of the whale. When he went off in anger and thought that we should, would not decree anything upon him, will not make it difficult for him. And he called out within the darknesses, darkness of night, darkness of the sea, darkness of the whale. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned darknesses. There is no God worthy of worship but Allah, but you. Exalted are you. Indeed, I have been of the wrongdoers. Show your weakness to your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ayyub alayhi salatu wasalam, here in this dua, he did not say, save me, O Allah. He showed his weakness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also the previous one, you Ayyub, he mentioned, مَسَّنِيَ الضُّرُّ. Subhanallah. It touched me. Subhanallah. To be polite in your dua. Allah knows exactly what is going for you. So be polite in your dua. Don't show the objection that, oh Allah, I have nothing. All types of problems upon me, my family. Be polite in your dua. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows your problems and He will answer you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said immediately the next ayah, فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْغَمِّ. So we responded to him and saved him from the distress. Then he said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَكَذَلِكَ نُنْجِي الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And thus do we save the believers. So this is not only for Yunus, not for only Ayyub, for Nuh only. This is for them and for us, for all the believers. This is a glad tiding for all the believers. If you are believing in Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will see the answer. Inshallah, قُلْ مَا تَسْمَعُونَ سَخِ اللَّهِ يَلَكُمْ. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده ما بعد. After that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned Zakariya. وَزَكَرِيَّا إِذْ نَادَى رَبَّهُ رَبِّ لَا تَذَرْنِي فَرْدًا وَأَنْتَ خَيْرُ الْوَارِثِينَ. And mentioned Zakariya. When he called to his Lord, my Lord, don't leave me alone. He doesn't have children. He's an old man and his wife an old woman. So he said, oh Allah, don't leave me alone without children. While you are the best of inheritors. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, next ayah. فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ وَوَهَبْنَا لَهُ يَحْيَى وَأَصْلَحْنَا لَهُ زَوْجَهُ. Allahu Akbar. So we responded to him and we gave to him يَحْيَى and amended for him his wife. It is not only any son. Allah gave him a prophet, Yahya alayhi salatu wasalam. And from his name, this glad tiding, Yahya, from the word al-hayah, the life, he will live. He will not die as an infant. Yahya. Wa aslahna lahu zawja. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned why. He answered their invocation and supplications. إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ وَيَدْعُونَنَا رَغَبًا وَرَهَبًا وَكَانُوا لَنَا خَاشِعِينَ. Indeed they, it means Yahya, it means Zakariya, ونوح ويونس وأيوب, all of them. إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ. They used to hasten to good deeds. They pray, give charity, they fast, they fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It doesn't mean that Allah will answer you and when you are away from the masjid. You don't know how to pray. What is the time of the prayers? You don't know when Ramadan comes, when Ramadan finishes, or you don't know anything about Islam. Then you complain, what is the answer from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? If you know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will remember you. إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ وَيَدْعُونَنَا رَغَبًا وَرَهَبًا. And supplicate us in hope and fear. Hope, they want paradise. They want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant them paradise, to forgive them their sins. Warahaba, they fear the hellfire. They fear that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept their deeds. We need to follow their sibs. Are we fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or hoping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Some of the Muslims, subhanallah, I am a perfect person. I am a perfect Muslim. I am praying the five prayers. I am doing the taraweeh. I am giving charity. I am the best. Astaghfirullah. Don't think that you are the best. The prophets did not have this feeling. They were very humble. They fear that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept from them. وَكَانُوا لَنَا خَاشِعِينَ. They were to us humbly submissive. This is the main thing, brothers and sisters. Be humble for Allah. Submit yourself for Allah. سبحانه وتعالى. Show your weakness, Allah سبحانه وتعالى will answer your دعاء. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات, إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعل هذا البلد آمنا مطمئنا وسائر بلاد المسلمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم تقبل صيامنا وقيامنا, اللهم تقبل صدقاتنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنا على إتمام هذا الشهر كما تحب وترضى يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين, اشف مرضانا وعاف مبتلانا يا رب العالمين. احفظ الشباب والبنات من المخدرات يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجمع المسلمين على كلمة الحق والتقوى يا رب العالمين. اللهم من أرادنا والإسلام مسلمين بسوء فرد كيده في نحره يا رب العالمين. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.